Hello, my pack, my tribe. Welcome to Howling After Dark. Good stuff tonight. I want to explain something. I'm probably not going to be able to do a live EVP show for a little bit. As irony would have it, after the live EVP session I did on Monday night show, when I went to bed, I accidentally knocked my phone onto the floor and the battery basically hit the floor and exploded. So I don't have my app for now. As soon as I can, I'm going to replace it, but yeah, I just wanted you to know what's going on. Anyways, so tonight's show is about UFOs, and I don't do UFOs on this show very often. In fact, I've only done, in like the 3 or 4 years I've been doing the show, I've only done UFOs, I think, like twice. And it's not that I'm not interested in the subject or that I'm not a believer or whatever. I just don't have a ton of experience with it. In fact, I'm going to start tonight by telling you kind of like my story with it. I've always pretty much been open-minded. And I've always been hold on one sec. I've always been a believer, and the reason I've been a believer, I've always had kind of a different logic. I look at the universe and see how massive it is, and to me, and feel free to have your own opinions about it, but to me it seems like the absolute height of human arrogance to believe in a space so big that we're the only intelligent thing in it. Absolutely does not make sense, that particular brand of skepticism and cynicism. To believe for a second that we're alone in the universe, to me, is absolute bullshit. It just doesn't make any sort of sense to me at all. And once again, that's just me. But the truth is that while I've been an investigator for like a quarter of a century, and while I've seen spirits since I was 5, I have not had direct UFO experiences until fairly recently. Basically, since I lived here in Ohio. Now, the first one is one I really call bullshit on the news for this one, but I'll explain. I don't have, like, a backyard, per se. It's just, you go out my back door and there's steps, and then there's a little concrete area where we can set up a barbecue, and then it's all just like this grass lawn that's kind of shared by all the apartments around it. And just one night I was out there and I was smoking a cigarette talking to this guy that used to live here named Mark. And we were just talking, and it doesn't even matter what we were talking about, but all of a sudden, straight back, right above the apartment, right in front of me, there was this bright light that came on and stayed on. We sat there and watched it in that one position in the sky. It did not move. Like you sit there and watch stars, they gradually move. This did not move. It wavered just a little bit, almost as if something was propelling it just to keep it in place. And we would sit there and watch it, and like clockwork, and this wasn't just one occurrence, this happened every night for like 3 months. And every night that light would come on right about the same time, and right about the same time every night that light would go back off as if somebody flipping off of a switch. Now, what I personally think it was is a space station, but I have questions about it because of one thing. 3 months after this first occurrence, our local news station here, Channel 5 Fox News, at least I think that's Channel 5, whatever Fox News is, I think it's 5. Anyways, doesn't matter. Fox News local here, tried to explain it away as some type of natural gaseous anomaly. Now, if that were true, and it was some kind of gaseous anomaly, it would not light up that way on a schedule. Just would not happen. And always in the same exact position. We even went as far as to measure it against like the roof point of the building above where we see it. And it was almost like a straight line. It was just a little to the right. And it was like that for 3 months. And that was the first year I was here. And they tried to explain it away, and of course I didn't buy it, And that was really my kind of first experience with the UFO, because it is unexplained officially. I don't think in that particular instance we were dealing with anything quote unquote alien. I think more than likely it was like a space station that they were trying to keep secret or something to that effect. My second experience was just like a year ago and was very, very different. And I feel validated that I wasn't the only one that saw it in my group, and I'll explain this in a second, but there's a place in Wooster, Ohio called Shreve Swamp. Yes, Ohio has swamps too. And this particular place is a game preserve, and we were kind of sort of there without permission. But the game wardens were really cool about it and everything. But I digress. But we were there looking for ghosts. We had no idea that we were about to experience a UFO that night. And I've got my camera out. I've got my phone out to use the apps, and we were just getting things going, right? And I had just taken a picture because I'd seen movement out of the corner of my eye on the left side, and there's kind of water on both sides of this road. And so I took a picture, and there actually was something in it, but that's another story. But anyways, also one of our other investigators took a picture in the same place, and what they caught was even more astounding. It was the spirit of a horse towing a boat. And you could actually see a guy in the boat, and it was pretty amazing, actually. But anyways, back to the point. We just both of us had just taken that picture, and right in that spot, we just happened to look up, and we see this light. Now, initially, I think I even mentioned it, and it might even be on our EVPs if I can find them, that initially I thought it was like just a plane or something. And it actually took me a minute to realize that this was no freaking plane. It was no helicopter. It was no weather balloon. It was none of that shit. I have no doubt in my mind that this is the real deal. Because what this thing did is you see this bright white light, and it kind of flickering blue, kind of around the edges. But it wasn't flying around like a chopper or a plane. It was stationary for a good 20, 30 seconds at least. And then it dips down really fast, almost so fast that I lost it. Goes to the right, which would have been our south, and then shot straight up, like even higher than it was initially. Comes down a little bit and then shoots off to the south. And that's the last we saw of it. But anyhow, I have no doubt in my mind that that was the real deal. That's not something, but that is not something you can explain to people. Like with anything paranormal at all, you have believers and non-believers, and then like there's kind of subsects of both. There's like with non-believers, there's skeptics and closed-minded. With believers, there's kind of like, well, yeah, we believe, but we don't think it's a good thing. It's all negative, blah, blah, blah. And then you have those that believe, but they choose to see things in a positive light. And I tend to be one of those. Which is why I think that the paranormal world at large is something that needs to be protected, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it does drive me bananas a little bit when people just shut things down. You know, when they're so close-minded, a UFO could fly right in front of their face and they'd completely deny it. That shit kind of pisses me off, but, you know, that's me. Anyhow. One momento. Let me bring this up. There's a few sites that I go to for paranormal related stories, like when I do paranormal news, etc., etc. And there's some that I like and some that I don't. Let's see, I think I passed it. Yes, I did. I just love when I... pass stuff up that I'm trying to find. Dang it, where is it now? Here we go. Okay, waiting for the page to load. But here's the interesting thing that I think that the more close-minded people haven't taken into account, and I don't think a lot of the believers have taken into account either. But there seems to be a connection between sightings around the world, because there's too many similarities in a lot of these sightings. For example, I think it was last year, it might have been 2014, there was an occurrence that happened in Phoenix, Arizona. Something that they now call the Phoenix Lights. And what it is it was these three lights that appeared in the sky in a triangular formation. They didn't waver away from each other. It looked as if they were all connected, and it moved across the sky in perfect formation, as if they all belonged to one vessel of massive size. And then the same thing appeared in, I think, Pennsylvania. Okay. This is from today, actually. ISS spotted clear UFO flying saucer and I'm going to post the image in the website for those that want to see it. Come on, why aren't you posting? That's only going to let me do the link. Okay. Okay, so this is the link I'm at. It's UFO Sightings Hotspot is the name of the site. And it's the top story there, you'll see it. Let me try this. Maybe I'll. Might be too long. Nope, it posted. The article says that okay, normally after a shutdown, we see the following text: "Please stand by. The high definition Earth viewing experiment is either switching cameras or we are experiencing a temporary loss of signal with the International Space Station." But this time NASA went straight to blue screen, which means they are not switching cameras, they are not experiencing a loss of signal, but NASA just cut the whole ISS live feed transmission. However, StreetCap One recorded the first 9 seconds before NASA abruptly cut the live stream. NASA's actions prove again that they hide the truth about UFOs and prevent the general public from learning that aliens are visiting Earth. Here is the video of the flying saucer recorded on December 8, 2015. Let me see if there's a link to the video. Here's the link if you want to watch the video later or now or whatever. Somebody's named AO Alien says, I'm not saying it's aliens, but it's aliens. Oh, I know who that is. Okay, so anyways, next story is, yeah, I'm not getting into the ancient stuff. Let's see. UFO buzzes airliner in Germany. This is on December 5th. Recently, a passenger aboard a jetliner flying above Germany records an unidentified flying object moments after it flies directly under the plane. The unknown object has a kind of vapor trail which would suggest a conventional type of propulsion. It almost looks like it could be a missile. However, this sighting still remains a mystery. I'm gonna go ahead and copy this image too. There you go. Yeah, that's pretty much all it says about it. But there is a video. I'll go ahead and copy that too and paste it in our chat. This one can, just the headline alone will probably tell you why. It says, weird human-like figure appears in the sky above or over Solo, Indonesia. A mysterious and unexplained phenomenon appeared in the sky over Solo, Indonesia on November 30th, 2015. The person who took a picture of the strange phenomenon wonders if it could be a hologram depicting a human-like figure or cloaked unidentified flying object. Could it be a flying humanoid? Beings have regular human features like us, or is it something from another world? That's a good question. But here's that picture. And then there's also kind of a close-up. Now, personally, I've studied a lot of UFO stuff this past year, and I'm still learning, you know. But what I apply to my research is my knowledge of photography and filmography, because I am the guy you want to put a camera in my hand. Since I see spirits, I'm going to catch something. And as such, I've made it my mission for 25 years to know everything I could know about photography and film. And it looks to me like possibly a hologram, maybe. Because it almost, like, when you look at it close up, it looks kind of gaseous almost. But there's definitely a shape to it. And or it could just be a weird optical trick in the camera. It could be a smudge on the lens. I mean, I'm not saying that this is real. I'm not putting my stamp of approval on it. What I'm saying is I need more information to form an opinion. But it says, whatever it may be, global observations indicate that unusual sky phenomenon continue to escalate in both frequency and intensity, leaves one wondering, will it manifest itself further? Blah, blah. Now, this one I thought was pretty interesting, because we've been going back and forth on this one for a while now. Whether or not there's life on planet Mars. Now, we know from soil samples taken from Mars that some form of primitive microbes do exist on the planet, or at least did exist. But they're going back and forth now on, well, you know how it goes. I mean, look at the whole Bigfoot situation, all right? Like, here we are in an age where we have DNA, and DNA has conclusively proven that both Bigfoot and the paranormal are real. Yet, closed-minded skeptics, being what they are, have to come up with some freaking thing to like explain it away. And they're doing the same thing here with this story. What it says is little creature photobombs Opportunity Mars rover picture. It is not only the fact that animals on Earth know the right timing to photobomb. Now it seems a photobomb trend has spread so far that it has reached planet Mars. A little creature with big eyes took the opportunity to get in front of the camera of the Mars rover just at the moment the front has cam of the rover took a picture of the surrounding area. It may just be the imagined perception of a pattern, what actually does not exist, a phenomenon also known as pareidolia. And pareidolia, I'll get into in a minute, but in my opinion, you can clearly see a very small animal head, left big eye, tongue, legs, and tail that lies on the ground. And here's the picture they're talking about. I'm gonna go ahead and post this. Now, I want to say something about pareidolia. It is a real thing. Okay, and as paranormal investigators, we have to be very careful about it because what it basically is you take an image and maybe the image is a little bit hazy or fuzzy or whatever you want to call it, but there's something there. And so what pareidolia says happens is that we see that anomaly in a photograph or on film, and our brain makes up what it is in our heads. Now, that is a real phenomenon. We do know that actually happens, which is why it's important to debunk everything, especially with video and photography. Because we have to be able to say, yeah, that's not pareidolia. That they're gonna find some explanation to explain it away, but they're full of shit, in other words. And yeah, to answer the question that's just asked in chat, according to the person or persons that posted the image, that is the creature's eye. Let me see if they've got a close up of it. No, they do not. Yeah, supposedly you can clearly see like a leg, an eye, and a tongue sticking out. I don't know, to be honest with you, if that's what it is, or maybe it's just a weird rock formation that kind of resembles something. I don't know, but I'm not going to sit here and say that it's definitely not, whatever. What the? Okay, I'm going to another story. Okay, why? This is from December 4th, but I don't understand why this is a big deal now. We already knew this. It says NASA's New Horizons spots mystery rogue planet beyond Pluto. Something strange emerged when Scott F. Shepard from the Carnegie Institute of Science and his colleague Chad Trujillo of the Gemini Observatory compiled data for the orbits of Sedna 2012 and 10 icy objects that lie close to Pluto. Similarities in the 12 objects' paths around the Sun strongly suggest that all 12 are under the spell of a hulking far distant planet, Shepard says. Let's see, scrolling down, and I'm going to post this picture too. I kind of see what they're seeing. It, if you look in the big red circled image on the picture, that big bright whatever it is in the center is what they suspect is a planet, and the littler ones around it are being pulled towards it, is basically what they're saying. Or being pulled into its orbit, whatever. Oh, there's video too, so I'm going to go ahead and share this. But okay, this is kind of unrelated, but since I read this story, I want to make something very clear, and this is just my opinions, my ideas, my whatever, but and I'm going to end session one with this most likely, because I've got 3 minutes left, but according to, I guess, NASA or whoever defines what a planet is, Pluto is not a planet. Okay. I disagree. I wholeheartedly disagree. Because when I was growing up, I was taught in school without a shadow of a doubt that Pluto is a fucking planet. And no skeptical freaking dumbass is going to sit there and say that it's not a planet. It orbits the sun. It's a fucking planet. It doesn't matter that its orbit is a little bit different than ours. It still orbits the fucking sun. Yeah, it's so far away, it takes a lot fucking longer to do it. But that by definition, because it orbits the sun, it has an atmosphere, it has moons, that qualifies it as a fucking planet. I don't give a shit what they say. So, yeah, I just hate that shit. Like, when they try and change the rules to fit their skepticism, that shit pisses me off. And, oh, to be clear, I'm talking about closed-minded people than actual skeptics. Skeptics are cool. Skeptics are the reason why we have science behind everything. Because they're the ones that want evidence one way or the other. I have a problem with closed-minded people because they don't give a shit about evidence. They've made up their minds. And yeah, that is a problem, and it kind of fucking pisses me off, but whatever. Anyhow, I've got about 50 seconds left, so I'm going to go ahead and end session one here. Do not go anywhere. I will be back with session two. And don't forget to refresh the page in case you don't hear it automatically. But hopefully you will. All right, be back in a minute.